Guys, if you want global penis size to increase, you've got to change the rules. It's New Year's Eve, and this is my last video for this year. Time for a special edition on penis size. But it actually starts with beaks. Only a few days ago, the New York Times printed a small note on the dark-eyed Junco. That's a bird that's moved from the forest to the UCLA campus. Sparrows don't have penises, but here's what's interesting. Their beaks underwent a rapid evolutionary change, and that's something that's very interesting in penile terms. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, board-certified urologist and interested in birds. When the Juncos moved into the city, they started to live on junk food, though I doubt that's where the name came from. They ate leftovers from students. As a result, researchers observed a change in beak size. It became shorter. Then COVID arrived. Lockdowns, online lectures, university was closed. Then something remarkable happened. Within 2 years, evolution hit the entire campus population of juncos. Newborns had longer and slimmer beaks, similar to their relatives in the forest. The takeaway? Human behavior can trigger evolution fast. We used to think that evolution takes hundreds of years. Maybe that's not the case. What happens with beaks could happen elsewhere. But here's what the article doesn't say. If it happens in other species, it might as well happen in humans. So the question arises why penises aren't larger. If you asked men, a substantial proportion would trade in theirs for a larger specimen. Why didn't evolution have mercy with desperate men? The answer could be an unpleasant one. Penises are the size they are because there is no evolutionary pressure. I know there was a study several years back that stated that penises had grown by almost 25% during the past decades. I uploaded several videos on that article. The data is flawed because a lot of self-reported measurements are included. I will link you the videos in the end. If we speak of human evolution, the critical variable is female. What research has shown time and again is this: women don't care that much about penis size. Men do. But for evolution, it would be necessary that women did as well. Let's be honest, evolution only gives you two options here. Either women never have kids with a guy whose penis is under 6 inches, or men with penises under 6 inches never have sex with women. Now, sex alone wouldn't get a woman pregnant, but in the heat of the night, contraception might fail. Given the rapid evolution of the dark-eyed Junco, in theory, penis size could indeed increase within 30 years. Even if it worked, would it actually make men happier? That's the crucial question. Most probably not, because 6 inches would be the new 5 inches. The problem with penis size is variability independent from the actual size. Comparison is what makes men want to go full blue whale. In extreme thinking, suppose men had penises like the blue whale. And guys, we are talking about up to 118 inches or 3 meters. Everybody would still go, "Oh, I'm too small," because everybody else would be anatomically similar. These are my last thoughts on the topic for this year. Gives you something to think about, doesn't it? And in case you didn't understand what rules you will have to change, I gave you a hint in the middle of this video. Here are my thoughts on the article about penis size I mentioned earlier. A happy new year to you all. Thank you for being loyal fans this year. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, always copied, never matched.